The writer in this video says sleep deprivation is what caused this, but I've seen a few of his videos, and I don't think that's the case. If you're looking for a way to put your phone on the motorcycle, why don't you check out Rockform? Great product, I bought it myself, and I use it every single day. So what went right, what went wrong, and how we can use any of that information to prevent an accident for us? So I said in the intro that I've seen a few of his videos. This is not going to be the only video I'm going to be doing an accident scene analysis of. There's other ones. So let's go ahead and talk about this. So I have a feeling that this rider is highly reckless and has poor judgment when it comes to a lot of his riding. So right off the bat, I do have an idea of what kind of rider he is, and it's not going to be the safety-oriented type. So he's going to be a high risk, low skill. So we're gonna move on to this. We have buses in the way, we have people merging, we have pedestrians, we have a light signal change. We just have a lot of stuff going on. And a lot of times when you have a lot of stuff going on, it's best to just sit back and watch everything and then make decisions based on what other people are doing. Let's not interject ourselves into a situation. So let's go ahead and watch this. He says he's dumb, he knows, and he puts himself in a situation that he's gonna get hit in, and that's not very smart. So right here, he says he was half asleep and stupid enough to think he saw me coming. So self-deprecation is going to be a good thing right here, because at the end of the day, it is this motorcyclist's fault. But if you want to watch the full video, I do have a link in the description, and he's going to argue his point to the driver. So let's go back. That's pretty much what happened. And when we go back, we're going to discuss a lot more. All right, show of hands, everybody. Do you know anybody that will walk into the middle of the street and then when you protest that they're doing that, they'll say, what? Cars are supposed to pay attention. I have right of way. That's kind of what's happening here. He thinks he has the right of way because the flow of traffic is supposed to be maintained and this person's in his way. That is not the way to do it, okay? So when you're out in this position, just wait or go around to the left side like the other motorcyclist was about to do. Just wait, everybody. I understand that he's probably not supposed to be in that spot. He's supposed to be fully merged. He's blocking traffic, all these different things. But does that give you the right to do that? Okay, let's not do that. We just put ourselves in a spot that's going to cause us to be injured. And now we got to deal with insurance companies and possibly the hospital, because this type of impact right there is going to be on your left leg. That is a crushing injury. There are so many complications and so many issues with a crushing injury to the lower extremities. Let's prevent ourselves from actually having that. So we're going to scroll back right here. This was very poor judgment based on what he says. He's being sleepy. He's being tired. Sleep deprivation. Is it sleep deprivation, everybody? Do you think this is a sleep deprivation issue, or do you think this is just him being not a courteous rider? Let me know in the comments. Let's go ahead and have a discussion about that. And let's just give him the benefit of the doubt. Let's say he was very sleepy. Sleep deprivation is going to cause a lot of issues. You're going to have really bad judgment. You're not going to be able to see very well. There's a whole litany of things. It's pretty much worse than drunk driving. I think there's studies that say it is. So if that's the case, let's make sure that when we're riding, we're actually doing stuff, let's make sure we are high alert, okay? Let's zone in, not zone out. It's easy to zone out when you are super tired. You're thinking about getting home and relaxing. You're not thinking about the ride itself. So let's make sure we have a good night's sleep. Let's make sure that we have enough energy to make it home. And if we have to, let's do quick little spurts of 10-minute ride, take a break. A 10-minute ride, take a break. 5-minute ride, take a break. Whatever we have to do to make it home with 100% alertness, okay? But there's no reason to do that. That is a terrible decision. And like I said, I've seen a few of his videos, and this isn't going to be the first accident video that I'm going to be talking about. Tomorrow is going to be the next one, so make sure you check that one out. Yeah, this is not a good idea to jump in front of somebody, especially when they're trying to get in line, okay? See the other motorcyclist? He was ready to go to the left side of this driver. That's something that AJHD should have done. But yes, what can we learn from this? What went right? He's wearing gear, I guess. What went wrong? He made a lot of poor judgments, and this was all on the motorcycle rider, not on the car driver. And what can we learn from this? Let's make sure that we stay awake. Let's make sure we stay alert, take breaks if we absolutely have to. And let's not jump in front of other cars, because that is a bad idea. Let's be a courteous rider also. Let's let people in and just let them do their thing and let them get out of the way. And then let's go. I said a let a lot. Anyways, if you like this kind of stuff, make sure you hit that subscribe button, hit that notification bell button. And if you really want to help with the channel, share this video. It really helps out the channel when you share a video, because then that means somebody else will learn proper safety measures when it comes to riding a motorcycle. That is all I care about. I want you guys to be careful. I want you to be confident, and I want you guys to ride safe. Okay. So like I said, with that said, hope you ride safe, be safe, and I'll be seeing you around.